Happy morning, children. Welcome back. This is your English online class for standard 5. Open your course book to page number 143. You could see the topic types of sentences. Just a definition is given in your textbook. Can you see that in 143? Grammar, types of sentence. Yes. A sentence is a set of words that convey complete meaning. We say sentence. What is a sentence? A sentence should give you proper meaning, sensible meaning. There should not be any break. Okay. Here, there are four types of sentences. A statement, a command or request, a question, express a strong feeling. You all know this. A statement is nothing but declarative sentence. Okay. A command or request is nothing but imperative sentences. A question is nothing but interrogative sentences. Express strong feeling is nothing but exclamatory sentences. Okay, now let's see in detail. You all know this. You have already learned this in class 3 as well as in class 4. Children, this is in your course book, page number 144. Open that page. Let's read that. There is a tabular column. Can you see what are the functions of the sentences and how they end, and one example? Let's read. Okay, read along with me. Sentences that say something are called statement sentences. It ends with a full stop. Example given here is I'll certainly try. Next one, sentences that give commands or make requests are called imperative sentences, ends with a full stop. Just one example given here is oil my elbows. Then, sentences that ask questions are called interrogative sentences, ends with question mark. And the example here is how did you get stuck here? The last one, sentences that express strong feeling are called exclamatory sentences, ends with exclamation mark. Then the example given here is it's good to be free. Did you read along with me? If you feel that I was very fast, you please play back and then read slowly. Okay, children, let's see in detail one by one, right? Types of sentences. Now you have to look at the screen. It is not in your textbook. First one is declarative sentences. They are a statement. Declarative sentences are nothing but a statement, or you could say just an information, piece of information, facts, or your opinion, your ideas. And those sentences ends with full stop. I've given two examples here. London is the capital of England. Okay, it's just an information, and also it is true. Okay. She asked whether I liked her dress. Can you see? It ends with full stop. It is just a statement. Clear? Then imperative. Imperative sentences gives you commands or a request, and they end with full stop. Look here. Example. Pass the salt. That is, you are commanding. You are just asking your friend sitting next to you to take the salt box and give to you. Pass the salt. Please be quiet. That is, you are giving a request. Please, because you're using please here. Please be quiet. Please tidy your room. All these are request. So without using please, if you're going to say a sentence, that becomes a command. Listen. Listen to me. That is command. Please listen to me. That is request. All these are imperative sentences. Now the next one is interrogative sentences. That means which ask questions. And it, of course, ends with question mark. Look at these two examples. Can I borrow your grammar book for a day? See, there's a question mark. How did you make that watermark? Question mark. When will you meet me? Question mark. Shall we go out? Question mark. All these are interrogative sentences. Right? It ends with question mark. You could easily find out. Then, exclamatory. It expresses strong feeling, surprise, emotion, and it ends with exclamatory mark. Can you see this? Exclamation mark. Yes. Hooray! It will rain again. This is exclamation mark. How well she sings! Exclamation mark. So whenever you express your feeling, you talk about your surprise, when you show your emotion and say a dialogue, you will use this exclamation mark, and that is exclamatory sentences. Hooray, alas, oh my god. Do you understand all these things? For all these sentences, you will be using exclamation mark, and that is called as exclamatory sentences. That's all. Clear? And now there is an exercise in page number 145. Turn to page number 145. Yeah. Read the sentences from an Aesop's fable. Notice that the fable has different types of sentences. Identify the type and write it in the space provided. One has been done for you. Okay. You are going to do this now. You have your pencil with you? Yes. Let's read the sentences and check out what type of sentences, and you are going to write in these gaps. Clear? So it's a story actually. Aesop's fable means it's a story. Sentences are given from the story. We are just going to check out what type of sentences. Now let's do the exercise, children. Be ready with your pencil. Yeah. The first one is already done. One day a man came into a wood with an axe head. So this is just a statement which is declarative. Okay. A statement means nothing but declarative. Now let's move on to the next one. He asked the trees, "Can I have a small branch, please?" So there's a question mark here. Of course, it is interrogative, right? Now, don't write now. After we finish this exercise fully, you just pause and then write. Now, the generous tree said, "Here, take one." So what kind of sentence is this? It is just imperative. See here, "Here, take one." It's just kind of order, so imperative. The man quickly fixed the axe head to the branch. So it is just statement, declarative. The trees could not understand anything. This is also just a piece of information, just a statement. Okay, then they asked, "What are you doing, man?" They asked, "What are you doing, man?" There is a question mark. So this is very easy to find. It is interrogative. Now, the man said, "I am ready to cut you all down." So he is giving the information, that is statement, declarative. The trees realized their folly. Folly means mistake. The trees realized their folly is also just an information statement, that is declarative. They said, "How foolish we are." There is exclamatory mark here. Can you see here? So this is exclamatory sentence. "We gave our enemy the tool to destroy us." This is just a piece of information, so statement. See children, I have given statement hyphen declarative. Why? Because in your textbook it is mentioned as statement. So you should know statement is nothing but declarative. Is it clear? So I have given statement hyphen declarative. You could even write only declarative. This is only important. Okay, now you copy down. Pause this video and then copy down. Now let's do this exercise. This is your quiz pattern. Okay, identify the type of sentence. You will have sentences like this. You have to check what type of sentences. Listen, "Don't you like coffee?" There is a question mark. Of course, this is interrogative. In quiz, you will have some 2-3 options. You have to check out the correct option. That's all. Very easy. Is it not, children? Yes. "We watched TV last night." This is just a statement, so that is declarative. Clear? "Don't give him pocket money." So you are giving an order. You say "don't give." So this is imperative. Order. "What an exciting movie it was." Can you see the exclamation mark here? So of course it is exclamatory. "I'm very happy today." You are giving the piece of information. So that is declarative. "Please sit down." You are making a request. You are using "please." So this is imperative. So when there is order, when there is request, that is imperative. When there is question mark, interrogative. When there is exclamation mark, exclamatory. When there is just a statement, just a sentence, that is declarative. Easy, no, children? Yes. go through the video class, children, so that you will understand better. Some 2-3 times if you watch in a silent, calm place, you will understand the topic very, very easily. Okay. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.